doing a series on why should we go to church? Why should we come to a place like this? Why should we attend church? And for the last 5 weeks, we have been speaking with different reasons why attending church is so important. Today, we're going to speak about is to build the body, to build the body of Christ, to build us, a congregation. So we are the body. And we're going to be reading from 1 Corinthians 12, verses 12 to 27. That's going to read verses 12 to 14, and then 24 to 27. This is the word the Lord says. The human body has many parts, but the many parts make up the whole body. So is with the body of Christ. Some of us are Jews, some of us are Gentiles, some of us are slaves, and some of us are free. We have been baptized into one body by one Spirit, and we all share the same Spirit. Yes, the body has many different parts, not just one part. And then from verse 24 to 27 it says, God has put the body together such that extra honor and care are given to those parts that have less dignity. This makes the harmony among the members so that all members care for each other. If one part suffers, all the parts suffer with it. And if one part is honored, all the parts are glad. All of you together are Christ's body, and each of you is part of it. And this is God's word, and we give thanks for the reading of His word. Growing up, most of us have experienced traumatic experiences growing up. I'm sure all of us have had through some difficult times, especially for us men, when we are part of a soccer team or a baseball team, because we need to be chosen, or part of a soccer team or a basketball team. So you're a group of friends, and they want to choose the teams, they choose the captains, and then they begin to choose the players. And you're inside, they're choosing the players, you're saying for yourself or in your mind, pick me, pick me. And you tell yourself, well, no, pick me, pick me. We do that in our minds. Because we don't want to be the last one to be chosen. Because the last one is always, okay, Jose, you can come, you can play with me. And you always feel bad because you're the last one and say, oh, Jesus, I'm an afterthought. And it's not just boys, but also girls as well, when they're growing up, they will play things like house, or they have tea parties. They have tea parties where they invite mom and dad to have tea, and for them, what they invite their toys to come and join their tea party. And they play mom, and then they have the toys who then make up the family that they belong to. So one of the questions I wanted to ask this morning is, how important is a sense of belonging? How important it is to belong to something? Because growing up, we're conditioned that we need to belong. We need to belong to something. So is it important? For example, belonging is important or crucial in our own development. That will develop for the rest of our lives. For example, we label ourselves as members of a family. We label ourselves in sports teams, or faith groups, political parties, in cities, or countries, or nations. So in every aspect of our lives, we live organized, surrounding the others that belong to the same, or to something that is the same as the one else. So the sense of belonging is fundamental to the way we organize ourselves. If it wasn't, we would live like hermits. And we only come together for procreation, and then as soon as the children are born, we take them out of the house. Now we don't do that. And this is why we have communities, we have families, and we also have organized governments. So what's interesting is that belonging is an important condition of our physical, but also into our mental health. Because all of us need to have social ties to something. we are conditioned to belong, and it's also a protective factor that is able to manage our own stress. Because when we feel that we have support, we feel that we're not alone. This is how we can cope with in difficult times, when we're coping with sorrow or bad news, when we have a group that we belong to, a family or something that we belong to, we can help each other to cope with difficult times. So coping well with hardship increases the physical and mental impact of our situation that we're going through. So we grow up, and when we grow up, we are very attached to our mothers. So our upbringing is the fundamental need to belong, because we need to belong. Now, studies have shown that children that have not achieved the same of attachment in their young life, they suffer from things like low self-esteem, negative worldview, or they mistrust others, or they have the feeling of rejection. Some of them suffer depression, anxiety, or even suicide. So they're common with people that feel they're not attached to something, where they don't feel they lack a sense of belonging. So this condition leads to social behaviors that interfere with individual ability to connect with other people. So there's a sense of belonging. So what I'm trying to say, belonging is a fundamental characteristic of humanity. All of us need to belong. When God created the universe, He created the family. And when He created a family, as the family grew, it became more and more important for the family to be united. And as the family has grown, and over time has grown from one family into many, many, many nations, and God continues to work in the unity of the family and in the sense of belonging. So my first point this morning is there's unity in diversity. There is unity in diversity. Now, the pastor Paul, in this picture that we read, he speaks about using a reference of the body. The body has many parts, and these parts create the body. And each part is significant for the rest of the body, because as the body works, it requires every piece of the body to work together. And at the center of the body is where we find Christ. And Christ is wanting to work for each one of us. So Jesus is not just wants to work, but He wants to work through us, the body of Christ. If you look at verse 12, it says, the human body has many parts, but the many parts make up one another, make the whole body. So it is with the body of Christ. The body of Christ wants to work for each one of us. So as Christ wants to work through us as the body of Christ, because God is trying to work and create in us something that is meaningful for us as the people of God. So we are part of the church, and the church is the body of Christ. And we as the people, we create the body. And God is trying to work through each one of us in also to have a place that we belong. And this is why we come to church. Because we need to belong. We need to belong to a people that have the same traditions, the same learning, the same faith, so that we can encourage and learn from each other, so we can pray for each other, so we can grow together in faith. So when we are struggling, we can lift each other up. When we are failing, we can help each other up. And when we are successful in things, we can rejoice together because we are doing it together. So being part of the family, being part of the body of Christ, is an essential function of the body, because the body has a purpose. And every piece of the body has a purpose. It means that each one of you is a piece of the body. And each one of you is the purpose for the part of this whole body, that is the body of Christ. Now read verses 14 to 17. It says, Yes, the band has many different parts, not just one part. And thus, he also says, I am not part of the body because I'm not an ear and I'm not an eye. Would that make it less part of the body? If the whole body were one eye, how would you hear? If the whole body were an ear, how would you smell anything? So, again, Paul is using our great parts of the body, our human body. And each part of the body has a purpose. Each part of the body, the physical body, has a gift. That gift, if it's an ear, is to listen, if it's an eye, is to see. And when all work, all these parts work together in order for the body to function properly, until you miss them. What happens when you begin to miss a part of the body? What happens when your eyes begin to go? Do your ears begin to go? Or a kidney begins to fail? Or any part of the body begins to fail? The entire body begins to suffer. The entire body begins to lose something which maybe we have taken for granted. And maybe that we will know that it existed even though it was always there. And because we are taking for granted, when we miss it, because we don't have it, we realize how important it is for each one of us. So, in the same way, you are not here by accident. You're not here because you just happened to show up one day to church. God brought you here to this place because God loves you. And God knows your talents. God knows your gifts. And we, in the same way as the body of Christ, we are lacking the gifts and the talents that you have. Because as we lack the gifts, you come along and you bring those gifts that we are lacking because the body needs to function together as the body in order for the body of Christ to work together. So in other words, we should desire to be a family. We should desire to be a family, working together, living together. So we are called in the church, this is called membership. And membership means to belong. Because when we belong, we pray for each other. We encourage each other. We lift each other up in prayer. So there are many benefits when we are a family, when we are part of this family, because we desire to be one. So we're not here by accident. And we all need each other. In verses 19 to 21, he says, how strange a body would be if it had only one part. Yet there are many parts, but only one body. The eye can never say to the hand, I don't need you. The head can say to the feet, I don't need you. In other words, we all need each other. Each one of us that's sitting here or that's watching, we all need each other. You know, my wife often says to me and to Joelle, look guys, I'm sure I'm not going to have another mess here. Can the woman relate to that? And she will say to us, I'm not the only one that makes the mess. So what do we do, as men and the boys, we get up and do something about it. Because all of us make the mess together. So in other words, if my wife wasn't there, guess what would happen? The mess will continue. I'm not saying that she's the only to clean the mess. But she's there to be part of the body. And we're there to work together to bring unity to the family in the same way. You are here for a reason. You are here to be part of a greater body. And we all need each other. And the problem is, too many times we take each other for granted. And we forget why we are here. Because sometimes we like to do things on our own. But God has called us to be a family, to be a body, in order for us, the church, to grow, to be built, to be encouraged, and to be fruitful. That means that we respect each other. In verses 24, 22, and 25, it says, in fact, some parts of the body that seem weaker or weakest at the least or in least important are actually the most necessary. In verse 25, this makes the harmony among the members so that all members care for each other. Again, you never know your kidney until it goes missing. You never know you have a liver until the liver begins to say, hey, I'm here. You never know until those parts begin to fail. In the same way, if we had no Henry or we didn't have Brad here, they will miss you terribly because you're part of the body. But the rest for everybody else for that matter. Everyone here is part of the body of Christ, and everyone here is just as important as the person next to you. And this is what we have to work hard in respecting one another. Not in, and it's not just about me or you, but it's all about God. What God is going to do through us. And this is why it's so important that we encourage each other. Not just a church, but also everywhere that we are. Whether it's a church, at home, where we work, or anywhere, always encourage those that are working with you. Look at verse 26, it says, if one part suffers, all the parts suffer with it. And if one part is honored, all parts are glad. In other words, if one part is suffering, we're all suffering. In your own body, if a part of the body is failing, the entire body will fail. If you begin to fail, we begin to fail. This is why it's so important that we encourage each other. Tell your husband, tell your wife how much you appreciate them every week or every day. Tell your brothers and sisters how much you appreciate them every day or every time when we come together. How much we appreciate the consistency that works together to have the lasting pain. How important it is everyone that comes here. Because you might just come to be part of the fellowship, but you're also important to the body of Christ. Because you're here also praying together. So you could be praying, or you could be paying the bills, or you could be ministering like me is, but everyone has a purpose. And everyone is just as important as the next person. There's no one greater than the other. We're all one. And if we are to succeed, if we as a church, we are to succeed, we have to work together as a body of Christ. So we can learn about unity from our relationship with the church. God has brought us together for a reason. Because all of us have something in common. And that is the basis of our unity. The basis of our unity is our baptism in the Holy Spirit. In verse 13 it says, some of us are Jews, and some of us are Gentiles, some of us are slaves, and some are free. But we have all been baptized into one body by one Spirit, and we all share the same Spirit. All of us share in the same Spirit because God was bringing us together. It is the Spirit of God that has brought us to this place in order for us to exercise our faith together. So when we receive the Holy Spirit, we put on Christ as our role. So we put on Christ every single day. Acts 2, 38 says, and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, then you put and receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Galatians 3:26 and 27, it says, for you are children of God through the faith in Christ Jesus, and all who have been united with Christ in baptism put on Christ. So we are here together, working together, living together, sharing our faith together, because we have been brought together by the Holy Spirit in order for each one of us to grow. And that's what we have in common, is the Holy Spirit. that wants to live through us, that wants to work through us, that wants to enable us to do our purpose here on earth. Each one of you has a purpose in this place because God brought you here. It wasn't by accident that you came. God brought you here by the purpose of the Holy Spirit to come together. And God will use your gifts. God will use your talents because God is saying, we need you. We need you. And without you, we cannot go on as a ministry. In other words, we are part of something that is much greater than us. It's much greater than ourselves. We're part of a much bigger purpose, which is the body of Christ that has brought us together to this place. So how do we conclude? We have been united into one body by the words of the Holy Spirit. And God wants to use us. And you know why? Because we matter to God. We matter to the church. And we matter to each other. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Father, this morning for your word. We thank you, Father, because it is you that guides us and teaches your word. It is you, Father, that encourages, Father, through all times, Father. So, Father, we give you thanks, Father, for this morning. We thank you, Father, for your word. And Father, I pray for everyone that may be struggling, Father, with today's message. And I pray, Father, that your Spirit be able to speak to and guide us, Father, through these times. And Father, I pray for anyone that needs a nudge, Lord. Father, I pray that you speak to them, Lord. So, Father, give you thanks. In Jesus' name I pray.